Good morning, sir.
Very good morning.
Good morning to, sir, shall we start? Good morning to all the participants. The topic for today is internal check of establishment and expenditure claims. To take you through the topic, we have with us C.K. Damodar Pradhan, faculty, AFM. Good morning, sir. Sitara welcomes you to today's topic. Sir, now over to C.K. Damodar Pradhan for today's topic, please.
Good morning to all the participants. And thank you, Sitara, for giving me this opportunity. Dear participants, we knew that internal check is our prime job. In railways, suppose somewhere any fraud takes place, immediately either general manager or other PHODs, they look at accounts department. It is a kind of derogatory look. It is not appreciable look normally, which we don't want. Housekeeping activity is how important to us. Similar way, the internal check of the transactions is the most important and essential functions of, one of the essential functions of our accounts department. All of us, we should know this fact and then work for the improving the internal check mechanism, because our internal check controls, internal check mechanism, it will be checked or scrutinized by even audit, because we knew that the Deputy CNDG or DI Railways, one of his functions is to check that the internal check mechanism is suitable and susceptible for verification. So our internal check mechanism always should be in forefront or at high place on high pedestal of our accounts department, accounts people, accounts staff and accounts officers. The more efficient internal check we do, the less number of mistakes that may occur, and the misclassifications or mistakes, whatever we commit, or this will be minimized. So the ultimate goal is to see that all the transactions are taking place as provided in our codes or as provided in our manuals, as provided in the instructions issued by higher-ups. If we fail to do that, it will be a disaster. There is no meaning of existence of accounts department. In one case, actually, I will not take any names, but our accounts person has asked, sir, for so-and-so work bill is pending, I require funds. Immediately, my PFA said that I don't require two senior DN coordinations. By this comment, you can clearly understand what is our job and what is the job of executive. Job of executive knows very well what he is supposed to do. But I can say our accounts department should not put our feet into their shoes. into executions. We have to do our job. Suppose we fail in our job, we are failing our accounts department. So with this brief introduction, and one more point I will tell, and then we will go into the topic. Another important point which we have to see is there is technical revolution. I can say yes, it is a technical, not a evolution, a technical revolution in our accounts department. We have, because of the large number of vacancies, and we could not able to fill up the vacancies, we have to cope up with our internal check. The internal check mechanism cannot be compromised. So, one work which earlier used to be done by, say, 10 people, now it is required to be done by one or two people. All of us, we have been experiencing this problem. Hence, the computerization is the only way, and we took the computerization on a large scale, massive way, and those benefits we should get, and with limited number of staff and more repetitive transactions, checks we can give to the computer, and then we can concentrate on more most important other aspects which cannot be covered by the computer alone. Computer, after all, it will do the arithmetical checks. Some X, it will compare. X is there, Y is there, X is greater than Y, or Y is greater than X. These kind of things. Or suppose my previous advance, it was not covered, recovered up to 50%. So like that, these are all the things. So my basic pay is this much, and my DA percentage should be 28%. So that percentage it will do. Similarly, the totals we used to do previously on computometers and etc., that it is not required. So what is required to be seen when massive computerization took place? These aspects also we have to keep it in mind. When computerization or new systems are put in place, with that system has to be thoroughly checked by users as well as the CRIS, and wherever the problems are there, immediately they have to attend to them. Then only our internal check we can do as provided in the code books, as provided in the code books or as provided in the manuals, foolproof. No mistake will be there. So that is how we can do that with the advent of the computerization. So I can say it is a boon as well as a bane also. Bane, I'll let you know. What I would like to say is that whenever a new system has been introduced, right from the user, say our accounts clerk, to the accounts officer, whoever using those, they have to diligently, they have to follow.
Recording in progress.
They have to follow the protocol. Unless the protocol is, or provisions, whatever levels, at what levels the provisions were given, if we won't follow and if we compromise, disasters will take place. You may argue, sir, there were problems at even when manual systems were there. Yes, I knew. Even when a black sheep will always be there. I can say when PF accounts were used to be maintained, most of you may be aware or may not be aware, but whenever the annual reconciliation is taking time, the pencil balances we used to put on the manual ledgers, those pencil entries in the in the PF ledger, we used to treat them as a there is a sanctity for that. It cannot be erased. We will not erase them, and we will not tamper with that. But I saw most of you may be aware that umpteen number of times in many divisions and many railways, those were tampered, and say 1,000 rupees balance, it has been made 1 lakh rupees, and the amount was given to the subscribers, PF subscribers. We have seen, and in manual system, we have seen that say Damodar Prasad has applied for a loan, but that was given, that was taken to some other account, and some other person has taken. Even when there is a cashier who has to pay, duly witnessed by someone of the department, that also we have seen. So the problems we faced, and we have come up to this stage, and when computerization takes place also, if we witness frauds taking place, that means the internal check system is not understood by our own accounts people. Say for example, if my accounts people, they themselves, if they indulge in the they tamper with the account IPAS system, then with whom whom to blame? We have to question ourselves. So with this introduction, let me go through. First, I devised this in two ways. One is, first let us go through what is provided in the code, then how the systems, new systems in IPAS etc., how they were misused, and what are the changes that have been suggested. Let us go through, and then we will have a question session also, the last 20 to 20 minutes. So let us go on. I would like to know from all of you also, what is there in your mind on this internal check. Sometimes we'll be feeling that accounts provisions, whatever in the internal check that were there, no, it cannot be done. But mind you, whenever a fraud takes place, the railway board letters, they will come as provided in the code, why net and so on so have not been followed, or as per the instructions that we have given, so these instructions are not followed, isn't it? So when that is the situation, now let us go into the, because we should know actually the main problem with our accounts department is that normally when I joined also, whatever my predecessor normally on the table beneath the glass, he will keep some allocations and etc., or some things what we are supposed to do, and that only I will follow. We will never look at our portal provisions and what is there in that. Of course, mostly that may be correct, but hearsay, we'll ask subhead, or we used to ask the section officer, and then carry out our duties. Those were days gone. Now we have to know what is there in the system. Now, tomorrow at some time, computer has given like this, therefore I have passed. No, it is a lame excuse. So we should know what is there in the code, because everything what is not required, we knew. Simple totaling previously we used to do, that is not required now, because it is available in the computer automatically, it will give. So these are all the things. That means where we have to concentrate, and where we have to strengthen our check system, this we should have a clear idea. Unless we have that clarity in our mind, executive Vijaya and piche and our enforcement stamp laga ke check kiya kya? Yes, check kiya. Our section officer, because he thinks that there is a signature, he thinks that AA has checked and he will also not check. And then it goes to accounts officer because two signatures are there. Accounts officer thinks that they did their own job. How do you know that we have done a perfect job? Everything it is available in our code books. Let us see. We should know that in accounts code, para 1, whatever functions of accounts code department where were enumerated, some 7 to 8 points were enumerated. There, one of the important points is that the internal check with reference to rules, orders of the transactions affecting the receipts and expenditure. So, it is not related to expenditure alone. That is why for receipts also, we have got our internal, there is a traffic accounts office exclusively for receipts. We have got that office. So, with reference to rules and orders, we have to check. So, this is one of the important functions of accounts department. Inter alia, there are other functions. This is one. And another one is the prompt settlement of proper claims against the lender. I italicized prompt settlement of proper claims. Prompt settlement means immediately you have to do. If you delay the thing, that means there is something, ulterior motive is there. But when I say prompt, and it should be a proper claim. So don't be carried away. No, quickly you do. Sadhne bola, quickly you do. So let me put chapa and then put up to officer. No, no, no. That is not the issue. That is not which we wanted. We are meant for. Or for that is not for job for which we were paid. Just like the other day, I was making a mention that the CNDG department, it is not there to pat the railways or pat the government. It is meant for finding fault. So our job is maybe it is not palatable to someone else, but we have to do our job. When I said prompt, it is a codal provision that clearly says that we have to do prompt settlement. Prompt settlement means don't think that because Damodar Sahib ne bata di, so piche mar chapa mar ke patap kar do. No, never. It is proper claim. The claim should be proper. How do you ensure that the claim is proper? How do you know that the person to whom you are paying the salary is on our rolls? How do you know that the bill coming to you, either in physical form or in the system online, it is proper? It is original one. It is not a duplicate one. It is not a fictitious one. How do you know? So these are the things which we have to keep it in mind when we read about the internal check. So these two things, please keep it in mind. Internal check means it is not just it is the job of the accounts clerk. So whatever he puts up, aaram se mai sign kar dunga aur mai sign karne ke baad accounts officer bhi sign karega to chale jayega. Baad mein ghotala ho gayi to agar loss hua to kaun zimmedari hoga? Pure ke pure zimmedari hogi. Wo zimmedari wo alag baat hai. That is personal. But what about accounts office reputation? Accounts office, why we used to have one grade pay extra than our executive people? Please think. We are not meant to say funds nahi hai, funds kahin bhi hai to theek hai hum pass kar denge. Agar agreement DF mein hai to DRF mein funds hai, DRF mein are badal ke de do. मैं पास करूंगा, और उन्हें मैं हम बोलने की जरूरत भी नहीं है, उन्हें खुद बदल के भेजता है. यू न्यू प्रीटी वेल दैट एग्रीमेंट इज फॉर डीएफ डेवलपमेंट फंड, बट दैट फेलो सेंड्स फॉर डीआरएफ, एंड डीआरएफ फंड्स आर अवेलेबल, फंड्स अवेलेबल सर्टिफिकेट रहता है, एंड एग्रीमेंट यू वोंट सी, एंड यू आई वोंट सी. अरे इतना फर्क है, ये क्या है, ये डीएफ को जाना है, ये डीआरएफ को भेज रहे, क्यों भेज रहे? फंड्स अवेलेबल है तो भी कहीं भी फंड्स अगर रेवेन्यू डाले तो भी हम पास कर देते. ये है क्या इंटरनल चेक? दैट इज नॉट इंटरनल चेक. प्लीज सी व्हाट इट सेज, प्रॉम्प्ट सेटलमेंट, यस दैट वी हैव टू, बट ऑफ प्रॉपर क्लेम्स. वो क्लेम प्रॉपर है या नहीं है वो भी हमारा कर्तव्य है. हमारे इंटरनल चेक में भूल दिया. सो इंटरनल चेक माने तो क्या आप आएंगे? इंटरनल चेक इज द चेक एक्सरसाइज बाय अकाउंट्स ऑफिसर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ रेलवे एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑन द फाइनेंशियल ट्रांजैक्शंस. अब यहाँ पर फाइनेंशियल ट्रांजैक्शन माने तो बोथ रिसीट एंड एक्सपेंडिचर, दोनों पे हमारा अकाउंट्स ऑफिसर जो भी चेक करते हैं. अकाउंट्स ऑफिसर माने खाली अकाउंट्स ऑफिसर नहीं है, अकाउंट्स ऑफिसर एंड बिलो हिम whoever is interested with the job of internal check. ये किस लिए कर रहे हैं? Receive on behalf of the railway administration. ये railway हमारा accounts department किसके लिए काम कर रहे हैं? It is for accounts, it is for railways. We are part and parcel of management. When we are part and parcel of management, we have to do our job. We need not do synodial coordination job. We have to do our own job, and then see that why the finance is there to do internal check of the transactions. Otherwise, this bill passing or check writing, everything can be given to executive, isn't it? Yes, my words may be harsh, but you try to understand the reality. There will be a problem. Yes, I can agree. Suppose you won't pass the OTA bill, there will be a commotion. Because the people have worked overtime. But when you stop the overtime bill, you knew that it is a controllable primary unit. When it is a controllable primary unit, who has given you authority to go beyond the budget? Similarly, suppose some work charge post is there. Suppose the extension to the work charge post is not coming, forthcoming. Even then, you continue to pass the bill. Who has given the power to us? If you do, or suppose some sanction to a particular post is lapsed, what is our duty? Our duty is to send proper notice to concerned personal branch that yes, this is over. For next 3 months, I will give provisional payment. You please obtain the orders of the head of the office, and then for 3 months only you can pay. Then you have to stop the payment, and that 3 month amount also you have to keep under objectionable items. How many of us we are doing this? Not only that, when I am saying that the internal check, what you are supposed to do, suppose it is a revenue post, it is a work charge post, immediately you have to transfer it to the work, and we will never ask for a sanction memorandum. And when we don't ask the sanction memorandum, and the personal branch and in the executive branch, they stopped giving the work codes to which the work charge post is chargeable. Because we are not questioning. When we don't question, they do that, they take it our accounts department light. So these are all the things, these are the essential. I am not telling about the internet jargon. No, these are the essential things that are available in our code books. why we are not following them? What is the problem? Did anyone ask you that? No, even though it is a one charger post, you put under revenue only. Did any officer ask you? Never. They'll say, promptly you do, and proper claim you do. So this is what it was given in the accounts board. Then, with reference to what you will do internal check. You will do internal check with reference to rule position, with reference to the instructions, with reference to the standards of financial propriety, code books, manuals, SOP, kiska sanction lena, kiska le sanction de rahe hai. Is it at lower level only it is sufficient, or it should go to higher level? So these are all the things which we have to keep it in mind. Agar ek expenditure bill aaye to we will not look at the sanction memorandum also, or we will not look at the funds where they are available. If that is the case, then what for accounts department? Because our major heads, minor heads, sub major heads, sub head, detailed head, primary unit, everything, if it is now, it is there in the computer, and that can be passed by engineering branch itself. We have to keep the honor of our accounts department. Only by doing our job. Our job is internal check, and book section job is to do bookkeeping. If book section also does the internal check, then that means there is no rule, or there is no rhyme, or there is no financial discipline in our finance department itself. I'll tell a small example. In one of my division, all of you aware that whenever unpaid amount comes, that amount will come to our book section. And some fellow will be knowing that then immediately that fellow will come, sir, my galti se number galti se kiya, mujhe paise tanakha nahi mil raha hai, bahut ye ho raha hai hamara ghar mein, shor macha rahe pure log, to isliye mera account number ye hai, ye do bole to book section wale change karke de diye, to pay order pass kare, to pay order unhe khud banaye, to kya hota hai? Can you call it as internal check? ये हमारा इंटरनल चेक में चेक्स एंड बैलेंसेस, ये आपने सुने ही होगा, चेक्स एंड बैलेंसेस। ये चेक्स एंड बैलेंस क्या होते हैं? एक डिपार्टमेंट ये काम करे तो दूसरा डिपार्टमेंट दूसरे काम करते हैं, वो चेक करते हैं। हमारे अकाउंट्स में भी हमारा एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सेक्शन विल डू बिल प्रिपेयरिंग, because they are also accounts people only. Can't they pass it? No. Then when such bifurcation, when we are dealing with reference to our pay bills, then why a book section fellow can or should pass a pay order, prepare a pay order and pass the pay order, which is not his job? What he is supposed to do, he has to give that to the section where, to whom it pertains. So deposit ye mein dal do, if agar PF hai to deposit PF mein dal do, deposit pension DCR hai to pension section ko de do. This is how they have to do. Then that section, it is the responsibility of that section. You are not supposed to think of the other fellow work, to do other fellow's job. We have to keep that sanctity. Otherwise, there is no point of internal check. Agar unhe khud receive karke, unhe khud change karke, unhe khud pay order banake, unhe khud pass karre to, then where is the sanctity for our internal check mechanism, where checks and balances have to be seen? Where is check and where is balance? Then, one more important point is that all, any transaction, whatever we are passing, it is 100% checked before CO7 is prepared. That is the internal check. One more point is that test check. This test check, I'm sorry to say that it has become a farce. Why test check is prescribed? Different levels. Agar section officer ke check ke roop mein, check ke andar nahi aaye to, such items section officer has to. Agar jo bhi items accounts officer ke signature tak nahi aaye to, us wo items unhe chunna, select karna, and then he has to do that test check. And this test check, it is not finding fault. It is for improving ourselves. Always take it in positive sense. Abhi systemic test check bhi kara rahe hain, especially by J grade officers. We are inviting the systemic test checks. That is, a system, suppose books module, suppose budget module, or internal checking sections ka module, ek le lena. And wo kaisa kaam kar rahi? What are the defects in that? Wo system theek dhang se hamara dimag, because it is a computer, you don't think that everything is fine. If it is so, then why test check is required? No, not required. But test check is mandated because there are some items which we have to, some validations may not be there in the system. So those validations we have to ensure, and then suppose a test check mein aa gaya, to Chris wale ko bol dete hain, Chris wale change kar dete hain. Say for example, my agreement value is say 2 lakhs, already expenditure 2 lakhs ho gaye. And suppose dusra bill 2 lakhs ke upar aaye to, and if my system allows, or you leave about system, suppose manually also, if it comes to you, do you pass that bill? Then why you are not, why we are not applying that mind here? Because it in IPAS, actually, in IPAS, as soon as the agreement value say 25, beyond 25%, that check should be there. Of course, that validation is not there. Had that validation been there, that it, the bill would have been stopped at executive level itself. It would not come to accounts. Okay, that validation is not there. It has come to you. Because it has come to you, does it mean that it has become a proper claim and you have to settle promptly? I feel no. I have to apply, because the essential features of that internal check, if those items are lost in track, then such disasters will continue to take place. N number of systems, system improvements you bring. Suppose I say that these provisions are to be done at accounts assistant level, or these are to be done at section officer level, and these are to be done at officer level. Suppose such provision, such privileges were given, and I want to read my book, and the section officer has to go to market, so therefore he will give those privileges to our accounts clerk, and accounts clerk will use, right, top, bottom to top, all the privileges if he has done, and blaming him alone. So these are the things which we have to keep in mind. You have to be very, very cautious. Just like that, it has come, so therefore I will not apply my mind. And whatever trash comes in from executive, tomorrow we will put a bargain. We will put an embargo. Suppose budget, suppose 100 rupees is there, beyond 100 rupees, no bill can be passed. If that embargo comes, is it acceptable to us? For me as a budget officer, I am very, very, very happy, because for me, there will be no excess over expenditure. Excess of expenditure over our funds. I need not tell CNDG will be happy, and my parliament is also will be very happy. If we want, yes, that can be done. But what happened to our brain? Why we are not looking at it? Simply it has come from executive. So even though there are no validations in our system, because system is allowing, so I can pass against a 10 rupee estimate, I can pass 100 rupee bills. Against a particular allocation or against a particular source of financing, if I get the bill and certifications, mere certification is there, I can pass the bill. Is it that very poor standard of internal check system in which we are working? I feel I will discuss later on what are the items which we have come across. Even after I said prior to computerization, what were the problems? Yes, we have come to computerization. Even after computerization also, there are many, many things were improved. So to that extent, you did not worry. But where you have to worry, you are not worrying. Where you have to check, you are not checking. There, our accounts office is failing. Once we plug those loopholes, and if we apply our brain, had it been in manual system, will I pass? This is a question which we have to put. Once we do that, then things will all right. Then what is the remedial action that is to be taken? Writing to CRIS or raising a service request, all those things we can do later. But why we are keeping our brain shut to those items which are pouring into our internal check IPAS system? That is not envisaged. When privileges were not there, that is a different issue. But even after privileges also, if you are not following, then what is the use? That is most important. Then, this part, internal check of financial scrutiny of sanctions, this is done by our finance section, because they will examine whether that expenditure is required or not, and most importantly, the finance directed concurrency, if they are not there, then the propriety of competency of sanction and the propriety of sanction, these are the things which we have to ensure, especially in the elbow letters. These issues with the finance directed concurrence. Whenever any finance implications are there, the letter will clearly be seen. And nowadays, the finance directed also, they are signing on the sanction letter. So, competency of sanction and property of, once if this is done, our expenditure section did not do anything. Then, only thing is, the scrutiny of sanction. Whenever from finance section it comes, even in expenditure section also, we have to see that sanction is okay, and the sanction is for limited period, or it is for unlimited period. If unlimited period, now and then expenditure section can tell them again, go back to accounts and then get a concurrence because of expenditure. Huge expenditure is being incurred, whereas the rates have fallen. In such cases, always accounts department, as an internal checking department, expenditure section, it can always tell. Because that once sanction is given, we don't think that the sanction is, because it is permanent in nature, So it can be cut. Can be removed. Then the sanctions for a longer period and sanctions of permanent nature. Yes, we have to do periodical review. And all sanctions will be renewed that from the date of issue only they will be applicable. And back date, if it is given in the sanctions memorandum, it is okay. Then delegation made by competent authority. And if it is done, then whether finance concurrence is there or from that or not, we have to see. Because delegation is there, so I can do my internal check. No, even that delegation has been done with finance concurrence or not, it is the job of the internal checking section. Then the sanctions, if any is coming, whether they have competency to do that. That means as per our SOP, that authority is having the power. Then sanction is very clear. What is the work to be done and what is the payment that is to be made and up till what period it will be made and to whom it is payable, who is the bill passing officer, all these things it will be available. And the rule or order sanction does not contravene the general or specific orders. Normally, we will look into that. Suppose it is against to a particular order, then we will not honor that particular sanction in the internal check. You will ask them to go back to finance section. So, sanction is to spend a definite amount up to specified period, both in words and figures. If any difference is there, generally we take as words or figure as current figure. But even then, you can refer back to finance that this, there is a problem because sanction in the sanction memorandum something is wrong. You can always find fault and then return the claim to the executive department. And whatever expenditure that was spent, it is it on the same purpose for which sanction was awarded. That is most important. Sanction is something and the expenditure done is something. So sanction is for construction of the building. But the expenditure incurred and bill you received is for whitewashing. Will you accept it? I am giving very small examples which easily understandable. This language may be something different, but definitely the purpose of these instructions on internal check are very clear. Then, expenditure proposals, whenever we come, there will be a pre-check and post-check. To spend before the check is done. Whereas pre-check, always any other than post-check items. Any other claim, it is pre-check only, and that pre-check is also 100%. There is no laxity because our portal provision is very clear. It is pre-check only, and post-check, few items, very few items, like our impressed cash. Because some authority was given to the executive, let them spend, absolutely no issue. And when they come for recouping, then they give all allocations, whether they have received or not, DMTR particulars they give, and whether they have utilized it or not, that also they will give on the back of the voucher, accept it, and then recoup it. But you may be getting a doubt, sir, agar usme kuch galat hai, toh kya karna? Whenever, because already expenditure was already incurred, so there you cannot disallow. Only thing is you can put under objection. Because the expenditure already incurred. So an objection you can keep. And what is required to be done, you tell them. And then if you are satisfied with that action, then allow it, remove from objection. So this is about post-check. And one more item which I can say, the amount which you have given for local purchase to the officers. It is post-check you have to do. So such items will be there. There are labor pay sheets which paid at the station. They will be prepared at the station itself and they make payment. You need not worry much about that. So along with the station watches, it will come, and then you send to the respective division, and then they will accept it. And if any problem is there, they will raise the issue. So this is post-check. And pre-check, always 100% right. So this already I told. Then, competent to incur, proper estimates have been prepared and approved by competent authority for work. So that is always, estimates will be there. But beyond estimate, if any claim comes, are we following? Already I told. So we have to keep, even though, because it has come, the bill has come in IPAS, that means I have to pass, otherwise the contractor will be, or otherwise contractor will be, will not be doing the job. No, it is not your problem. It is the problem of executive. Let executive go for reappropriations. Or let executive, you will be, your internal checking section, wherever works register maintained, their people will be there, and they will be knowing that 80% of the expenditure has already been incurred, then the work cannot be completed within within the balance 20%. Then they knew that, yes, a revised estimate has to be prepared. Let them prepare the revised estimate. Why you are breaking your rule? Okay, let him say that, no, yes, 20% it will be done, and here and there some 5% extra will be there. I will explain in completion report. Please allow. Okay, put up to accounts officer and then take orders and then clear it. There should not be any issue. Suppose even such things also, if I give to IPAS, then you cannot pass the bill. Tomorrow, if the internal check frauds, crores and crores of rupees, if it is going to happen, then tomorrow such embargo also will be there, such validations also will be kept. Then we will be happy. The bill will not come to us at executive level only, it will be stopped. If the system is worsens to that extent, it will happen. Then covered by the grant of, this also we are not seeing. Their cash portion in the IPAS it will be there, but even the validation is not there. We are passing, even it goes beyond that. It is indicating, that it is showing that 100 rupees only available, but you are passing 101 rupee bill also. Why you are passing? Because it is allowing. Tomorrow's validation is there, you will not pass. Then why you are not implementing now? And then why you will not do at that point of time when validation comes? Why we are not using our mind, applying that mind? Canons of financial sanction lifted. Period is not. This is one more important point. Suppose a temporary revenue post is there, or a work charger post is there, or the delivery period is so much only. Even thereafter, the delivery has taken place, and that should be covered by a memorandum modification to the PO. Or if it is a work, the period of completion, date of completion, it has to be modified through a subsidiary agreement. Suppose the quantities are going beyond 25%, then subsidiary agreement need to be entered into without entering into, without variations. And simply even the measurement book is recorded. And the bill is also prepared, and it comes to our accounts department. Even if we won't stop, then what for? These internal check measures that were given in the accounts report. Please, these are the things which we have to do. And one more important point, correctly classify. The executive, he may not classify. He as I said, he says that it is a revenue, new funds are available. Suppose in DRF funds are not there, or in RRSK funds are there, so he will give that allocation and simply will pass. Okay, for time being you are passed, but later on will you reverse it with, through JV? Will you tell to your boss that, sir, this is the problem, that is why I am doing like this? No. This is very, very difficult. And then one more point. Are we recording that properly? And then tomorrow, if same bill, once again it is signed, again in IPAS, if we won't reflect that with same voucher number, same amount, suppose some more bill comes, are we again pass the bill? Okay, it will allow. Suppose I am presuming that IPAS will allow. Then will you pass? What is that you are having in your hand? So contractor ledger you have to see. That also we will not see. Yesterday only we have passed. So therefore today we should not pass this bill. Same bill. And this is one more important point. Recoveries. On especially establishment section. Are we maintaining this recovery noting down? Of course, B branch they may be noting down. Suppose I say, you do in installments of 60, they may do that. But are we maintaining that recovery register at least now? One more important point. Okay, leave about internal check. In the internal check, it is also one important point that it says that on the prima facie, it is not irregular. It is not irregular. Everything is in order. But there is waste of public money or there is leakage of revenue is there. Do we keep quiet?
Recording in progress.
So when this problem is there, then it is our duty to tell them. In most of the cases, see this kind of action. This is available in our internal check. But we fail, and the audit will take care of this. Many times you may have seen many audit paras, they refer to this. When they do that, then why we are failing here? As an internal checking authority, why we are not following this? Why we are not finding fault? Suppose 25,000 can be spent in a station, suppose impressed you are given. And that impressed 10 lakhs, furniture repairs only you are getting. Absolutely there is no irregularity. In the internal check, 25,000 limit is there, 25,000 he is spending on furniture repairs. 10 lakhs you have passed. Is there any irregularity? No irregularity as far as internal check is concerned. But what happens to our ingenuity, that why he is spending on a particular purpose? That means the code says that beyond arithmetical things, you have to think, you have to judge that particular transaction. That is the most important. This, my today's session is only that because some mission is available and mission is doing some garbage, let us not take that garbage. Let us try to distinguish between what is water and what is milk. That is most important. In these years, age of computerization, this is most important, which we have to think. Then it also says, leave about our manuals. Even departmental manuals also, it is our duty to check. Many of our accounts branches, we do not have manuals also. When manual is there, then you can pinpoint and you can elaborate the procedure, what some X is to do and what Y is supposed to do and Z is supposed to do, you can have. believe about that. Even now, in this, or says, departmental manuals, other departmental manuals, if any are there, we have to check, go through them also, and check the records which are not coming to accounts, that is, through inspections, program inspections. In our accounts department, in Codal provision says that most experienced staff to be given in the inspection sessions, because they need to guide. They need to guide because they are in my division, and in my division, suppose they ask for some information or some suggestion, I should be in a position to tell. When I will be in a position to tell? When I have got experience. If I am novice and the executive is also novice, then what kind of guidance I can give? In the inspections manual, it clearly says that whenever a new office has come up, within 3 months, my staff has to go and then inspect. If we are not aware of the rules, and what is that, we can guide them. That is most important. Then, the bills, yes, already I told, variations, whether agreement, as per agreement, the quantities are there, any variations, modifications, and subsidiary agreement are there or not, funds availability certification is there or not, and that is also correct or not, and estimate provision not exceeded, allocation is as per the agreement or estimate, that, and agreement and estimate, are they in agreement? These are the things that we have to see in the internal check. Internal checking section is, it is not, it is the job, it is not, it is a wretched job, actually. It is not that rosy. So many things, of course, everything, it has a reference point. That reference point is our code, I already told. So many reference points are there. Check them. Because your IPAS is allowing, don't think that you can do whatever you want. So, proper certificate is coming that so and so. Suppose some XYZ engaged 4 outsourced person. So, 4 outsourced person, they have rendered service or not. Let somebody write in the executive. And some 10 pens I have received. Okay, 10 pens have been received. Okay, let them write in the voucher when it is submitted repressed cash recoupment, DMTR reference. Suppose leave salary they want to draw, let them send that leave account, whether that endorsement has been there or not. In the establishment terms, how many times you may have seen, especially in divisions, they are taking life of our people who are working in the stations. They'll say, leave account is not there, and the reconstruction. Yes, sir. At what cost? At whose cost? Then paid vouchers, of course, it has become redundant. It is important, but when all the vouchers that were paid, they have to come to our accounts department. If that is not coming, maybe that is a fraud bill, it is a fake bill, or wantedly that was it was not sent. When that paid voucher it is not coming up, also the book section, it gives acquittance. What kind of acquittance we are giving? Whom we are trying to safeguard? This is most important. The acquittance part also is related to our paid voucher. Then each voucher is cancelled, a post paid voucher check, like that they will do that stamping, whether this paid check nowadays, it has become most important. because in one of the cases, the paid vouchers were not available. When the paid voucher was not available, that means the transaction, original transaction itself is wrong, or maybe wrong. I can say we can presume that. So this is how. Whether the payment is account it is going or not. Suppose Damodar Prasad account is there in Canara Bank. So that Canara Bank account should go. And in the Canara Bank also, Damodar Prasad, instead of Damodar Prasad, it is going to some XYZ. Then is it, can we call it as a proper payment? Work was carried out by someone and we are making payment to someone else. Suppose I was not, the firm will give, please give to so-and-so account person who is authorized signatory. Suppose some authority is given, yes, based on that you can do. But in accounts office itself, we are doing changes. Then whom to blame? Then whenever the catering accounts, P&L loss account, we have to check. And then receipts and payments and correct preparation of P&L account, how much loss. The P&L account, whether it has been prepared correctly or not, and if it is loss making, let us make show it as a loss making only. If it is profit making, it is fine. If it is a loss making, let management take a decision. That is how it should be done. Then wherever the grant is being given, whether that grant has been sanctioned by proper authority, and for that purpose only that grant is being utilized, and no new grant is given. And if any unspent amount is there, that has to be remitted back in cash. And those grants, whatever, suppose for our institutes or for our clubs, wherever we are giving, or for our Kalyan Mandaps, whatever we are giving. So whether the accounts have been audited. And next time, whenever SBF funds are taken also, next time when it is audited, then the further grant can be given. So that is important with reference to the catering and grants. But I am stopping it here because it is not, the internal check is not related only to these. The internal check is related to debts and deposits, that is civil grants. Internal check is related to our remittance transactions. Internal check is related to other department bills also. And coming to the establishment check, it is most important that quick payment, as earlier said, for expenditure, a promptness, quickness is important. But the delay, accuracy is important as well as quickness. So this cannot be compromised, but the delay causes inconvenience to the staff. Suppose a driver, night duty he will be doing, and suppose you are not passing the bill, whatever sent branch, he has to come in daytime to you, and then he has to stand before you, wait till you come. Can he stand? Please think in those lines, especially establishment clients. Why a person should come to us? with that intention, we have to work. Then sanction of posts and claims, budget provision. Just like how expenditure, budget provision is important for controllable PUs. I can say controllable PUs like TA, OT, KMA, night duty elements, all these are controllable because they are pre-checked by you. So budget provision, you see. Without budget provision, you are passing establishment claims and thereby excess expenditure will be there, and pay bills in the computer environment, coding will be there, master data, each of data, because this is already given to officer level, then memorandum of differences, absent statement, scale check. Scale check is one of the most important, where the pinpointing is given and the number of staff that are available and for whom you are making payment, they are within the sanctions or not, and gross pay allowances, sanction to the post or not, is there a order of abandonment, you see, it is not a fake one, and date of joining, leave salary, whenever you are passing, you ask for a leave account of that particular period, and NPS, SCF 1 was taken or not. We have got umpteen number of, in one division we have got the provisional para, and in another division around 6 crores. One more provisional para is ready. The people are getting recruited, and we are not, we means, say, railway department, I am telling. The personal branch is not taking SCF 1 from them. And we are not, even though PRAN is available, PRAN is not available, and SAF details are giving a scope for audit department. So recovery list, wherever PF and etc. recovery lists are there, you, whether it is coming or not, and recovery is watched through watch recovery watch register, then pre-check of the TA, OTA, advances, LPC, now. Even though you can transfer on the machine, but LPC, that system is not removed. So that always you have to see. And input data and changes of the correctness is the responsibility of the bill preparing unit. They do that, but whether they have done it correctly or not. Suppose 10,000 rupees basic pay, 1 lakh basic pay is given. That is, you can see in the MOD. And there are now exception statements we are getting. In IPAS also, there are many exception statements that are coming, and those exception statements, the P branch, they can use, and we also can use those exception statements. On deputation, if someone is there, whether we are getting it or not. So these are the things we have to see, and especially in guested salary register, whether we are maintaining or not, service cards, leave account, and the leave certification, whether after doing they may not avail, or after availing how many days they availed, whether those things are coming or not. Cadre register, that total people are not more than the cadre strength, and sanction to the post in case limited currency is there, and assumption of watch of the currency, provisional payment, no pay beyond the superannuation. These things we have to do, and LPC, just like in non-guested, we have to see. And PF and pension, especially subscriptions, regular, it is there, recovery list is coming or not, withdrawals and advances properly as per the rules, IREM rules, whether we are doing reconciliation with the general books, whether we are doing it or not, issue of PF slips, transfers, transferring the closed account to deposit PF, when we will do, only when a person resigned or no subscription is coming and he died. In such cases, we'll wait for 6 months, and then we have to transfer it to close, treat it as a closed account and deposit PF. And in the deposit PF, we'll wait for 3 years, and then in the third succeeding year, we have to send it to earnings. Whether these things are being done or not, we have to see. And with regard to pension payments, verifying qualifying service, arranging DCRG, leave salary, all those things, it is one aspect. Another one is pension debit check. Those things also we have to see. So that on some other time we'll deal with that. So debit pension debits checking, how it is being done, whether this is being done or not, that we have to see. Then now, having said this, no, you have done internal check with the provisions, whatever it is available. Now, what is that you have to do? All the provisions, whatever internal check provisions are there, those internal check results, it has to be communicated to the executive. So, irregular payment, it will be disallowed. That means, prima facie evidence exists that it is incorrect. In such case, you can disallow it. Or pass provisionally pending regularization. So, payments made before the accounts office, that means impressed cash like, and found irregular during the internal check, we call it as objection. So, we will keep under objection for regularization. But prima facie, all other things, if any objection it is incorrect, then we call it as disallowance. Then, waiver of trivial objections, there are in the chapter 8 chapter, we have got certain things, and those trivial items, we did not put them under objection. Then, these disallowances, disallowance list, we call them for establishment claims. And other than establishment claims, if you find any mistake, then we put them under objectionable statements. Then departmental officers record their replies, and based on that, now you will be taking out from the disallowance list of establishment claims or objection statements. These are taken in the objection book. And then proper headings are there, want of estimate, excess over estimate, miscellaneous irregularities. This is objection book. So this will form the basis for your unsanctioned expenditure in Annexure A of appropriation accounts. And if anything, finally, suppose even executive whatever reply is giving and it is not correct, then in that case, you will be whatever you have disallowed finally, that you will be entering in the saving register. Please, all section officers, please note this. So this is the classification, okay? Then some subsidiary objection book, that is minor objection, petty objections. For that, you can open one register and you can watch. And all losses, serious irregularity, you have to keep separate register. And whenever audit comes, they will ask for serious irregularity register also from our internal checking sections. Then half-yearly review of this unsanctioned expenditure or objectionable items. It will be sent, prepared in the month of September and March. And September, in the month of September up to March, what are the objections? And March to September, how much we have cleared? And what is the balance in the September? That we will show. And in the March up to September, what are the objections? And September to March, how much we have cleared and what is the closing balance in March. So this is how we will be clearing. So this is all about the internal check of establishment and expenditure claims. Of course, I got some case studies for paucity of time. I am not showing them many frauds that took place all over Indian Railways. And remedial measures that were suggested by Railway, Railway Board, and internally by our PFAs, whatever instructions they were given, we have to unscrupulously follow. Any laxity at any level, it will be a disaster. With these words, I am closing. Now I am open for your questions. I am ready to take your questions. Dear participants, thank you for listening to me. Please treat this as a positive, that is, just I wanted to tell that because it is coming in the IPAS, that we have to pass duly compromising on the internal check. So with that intention, this webinar was organized. So now.
Yeah, participants, please ask your questions.
Nashagar, you can unmute them.
Yes, sir. All are unmuted, sir. They can unmute themselves, sir. Now we are allowed.
You can unmute all. Yeah.
You can unmute, sir.
Yes. Dear participants, any questions on this? Or rather than questions, I would like to listen to you. Aapka jo bhi aapka ideas jo hai, वो मैं सुनना चाहता हूँ. ये इंटरनल चेक स्ट्रेंथन करने के वास्ते हमें क्या करना है?
सर, देयर इज अ परी इन चैट बॉक्स आस्किंग बाय एनके नायक, एक्सप्लेन ऑन एमओडी ऑब्जेक्शन शीट.
बिरबल, या बिरबल भैया बोलिए. या
प्लीज एक्सप्लेन ऑन एमओडी एंड ऑब्जेक्शन स्टेटमेंट.
ऑब्जेक्शन स्टेटमेंट, या हमारा एक्सपेंडिचर में अभी तो इतना फर्क मैं बताया कि जो भी एस्टेब्लिशमेंट में हमें डिजलो करते हैं वो डिजलवेंस लिस्ट में डालते हैं. डिजलवेंस लिस्ट, सो डिजलवेंस लिस्ट व्हेनेवर आई एम टॉकिंग, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एस्टेब्लिशमेंट क्लाइंट्स. एंड ऑब्जेक्शनेबल स्टेटमेंट, इसमें जो एक्सपेंडिचर स्क्रूटनी में जो गलत आप समझ ही गया वो आपका एग्जीक्यूटिव को आप लेटर चिट्ठी लिख के, दिस इज ऑब्जेक्शनेबल, यू हैव टेकन द सैंक्शन ऑफ सो एंड सो, बट यू शुड बी सैंक्शन बाय सो एंड सो, और यू हैव एलोकेटेड टू सो एंड सो, यू शुड बी एलोकेटेड सो एंड सो, वेयर फंड्स आर नॉट अवेलेबल. सो लाइक दिस सम ऑब्जेक्शन यू विल बी टेकिंग. सो such items you have to necessarily write in the objection book. So in the objection book, whatever you are writing, those objections, whatever you are writing, those objections you will be sending in the form of a statement. Because khali hamara book mein likhne se koi fayda nahi hai, because action has to be taken by executive. Let them take action. So that is why you send that objection. These many objectionable items are there against your department. So please take action as mentioned in our letters dated so and so, so and so. Like that you please tell. That is called objectionable statement. And objection book mein jo bhi objection aap lete hain, wo objection aap teen tarike ka तीन कैटेगराइजेशन में डालते हैं. वांट ऑफ एस्टिमेट अभी नहीं है, एक्सेस ओवर एस्टिमेट जो भी है वो लिख दीजिएगा, और मिसलेनियस इरेगुलरिटी जो भी ऑडिट वाले पूछते हैं, और हमारे अकाउंट्स डिपार्टमेंट के हिसाब से हमारा इंटरनल चेक में जो भी मिस्टेक है वो पूरा उसमें लिख दीजिएगा. आप जो भी फाइंड आउट किए उसमें लिख दीजिएगा. एंड सपोज दैट फेलो हैज एग्रीड, दैट मीन्स द एग्जीक्यूटिव हैज एग्रीड, and they have come back with, yes sir, we are withdrawing that bill. Better, hai? Then you take that in the saving register. I saw in one case, in one division, say for my quarter, they have shown it as a whitewashed. But when I am there in the staff quarter, it was not whitewashed. Luckily or unluckily, that bill has come to me. Checked, then they withdrew that. So that has come in saving register. That is how we have to see. This objectionable items, it is one important area why we should keep. Because when the same objection is taken by audit, they will claim that this has been seen by accounts department, but it was omitted and we have taken that. So at that point of time, you can say that, yes, mister, it is not you who has found out. We have found out. See, in my objection book, it is available. This is how we can protect ourselves. Yes, please.
Yeah.
You increase your voice because today there is the net is not properly functioning. Yes, please.
I want, sir, position of very good and very informative. I just wanted to know what is the relation between the internal Chaitanya announced to Panda and Aurelia? Is there any relation?
Audit and internal check.
Yes.
Gotcha, okay. All right. Internal check and internal audit and audit. I am making three different parts. Internal check is what we do with reference to our quotal provisions, with reference to our with reference to our instructions, whatever they are available, with reference to the agreements, with reference to the estimates, whatever the claims that they come to us. So those items, whatever they are there, that is, we call it as internal check. But the internal check, I said that beyond internal check, we have to go for the propriety of expenditure and the transactions, whether leakage of revenue is there or irregular expenditure is there. If such things we have to take into cognizance, then normally such items will be given to
Sir, audio, please. Please unmute yourself.
So, the internal audit cell, it will be assisting the management. Whatever task they give, they do globally. Suppose say PAC items, procurement is on high side. So PAC procurement, whenever it is there, our internal check people, they'll do the bills checking, etc., etc. But globally, why they will not compile and then they won't look at and they won't see how many PAC items they are doing and what is the total purchases and what is the percentage. All those things they will not look at. So such activity, suppose some GM or PFA or our FASNW, if they feel that how many PAC items this time, this year, how they did and compare with the last year and give me a report. That will be done by internal audit. Apart from that, now the audit being the constitutional functionality, they also can do their in auditing. So their auditing, we call it as a statutory audit or external audit, we can say. So this is the major difference between internal check, internal audit, and external audit or statutory audit. But one important point is that the internal audit cell people, they can check on the internal check sections also because their role is bigger role. Their role is bigger one, and if any mistake in internal check are there, they are supposed to point out in their report. Mostly the reports what they give, they are all mostly used by our management, and mostly they are team based. Will be doing that on lines with the external audit. Internal check is, please repeat. You are talking about inspection section.
Yes, sir. Whether
Inspection section of our records department, it has got a limited role. It was clearly mentioned in our accounts code also what we have to check and what is the periodicity with which we have to check, and that will be followed by our internal by our inspection section people, that section officer or our account assistants. They do that job, but the topics that are given to internal audit cell are entirely different, and that will be given by the management. On so-and-so topic, you please check and let us know. That is what the mandate that will be given to our internal audit cell people. But whereas our general inspection, they do as per the codal provisions, it is also part of, we have seen now, it is part of our internal check. So as an internal check function, we do general inspections. So both are entirely different, and if any mistake is there, and that mistake they will be sending to the executive in the form of inspection reports part 1 and part 2, and closure we will be watching. That is entirely different, and the report given by internal audit cell, it is used by the top management. Yes, please.
सर देखा गया है एक्सपेंडिचर सेक्शन में फंड नहीं रहने के बाद भी जो है बिल पास कर दिया जाता है, उस स्थिति में अकाउंट को क्या करना चाहिए सर?
थोड़ा इलाबरेट करना, ये वॉइस ब्रेक हुआ, और एक दफा बोल सकते हैं आप?
जी सर जैसे सर कैश इंप्रेस में फंड अवेलेबल नहीं रहता है,
फंड अवेलेबल नहीं रहता वो कैश इंप्रेस में,
जी फिर भी जो है बिल पास करना पड़ता है, आखिर अकाउंट का क्या करना चाहिए जो इस पर जो है सर कंट्रोल हो
सके? सॉरी वॉइस ब्रेक हुआ, फिर भी वो इंप्रेस्ट में फंड्स अवेलेबिलिटी नहीं बोल सकते, क्योंकि हमें इंप्रेस्ट उसको दे दिया 25,000 या 40,000 कुछ ना कुछ पैसे दे चुके हैं, उसमें से उन्हें खर्च करना पड़ता है। वो खर्च करने में उन्हें वोचर्स लेते हैं, वो वोचर्स उन्हें रिसीव्ड सो मटेरियल बोल के भी देते हैं, और वो एलोकेशन भी देते हैं, एंड इट इज आवर रिस्पांसिबिलिटी व्हाइल रिक्यूपिंग दी इंप्रेस्ड कैश यू विल बी एलोकेटिंग देम एंड ब्रिंगिंग देम इनटू द बुक्स ऑफ रेलवे, दैट्स ऑल, दैट इज द इशू। अगर उसमें कुछ गलत हुआ, आपने आपका सैंक्शन मेमोरेंडम में कुछ पाबंदी लगाया एंड उसके ऊपर उन्हें खर्च किया, वैसा कुछ है, और आपने तीन शॉप से आप कोटेशन लेना, उन्हें एक ही शॉप से लिया, वैसा कुछ है तो आप ऑब्जेक्शन में डाल सकते हैं, डिसअलाउ करना ही कर सकते हैं इंप्रेस्ट में, क्योंकि वो तो पहले पेमेंट हो चुके हैं, तो इसलिए उसमें आपने खाली ऑब्जेक्शन में लगा सकते, डिजलो तो नहीं कर सकते। या प्लीज,
थैंक
यू। एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस प्लीज। और शुड वी क्लोज मनी साहब, क्योंकि इंटरनेट बहुत प्रॉब्लम कर रहा है।
Any more questions, participants? Okay. Sir, that was a very informative and detailed session on the internal check, sir. On behalf of the Academy, I thank the speaker of the day, Sri K. Tapandar Prasad, for joining my faculty room, for sharing his knowledge and his experience on the subject on this platform. Thank you, sir. Thank you. We might tomorrow's topic. we have, that is on Monday, we have a session on leave rules. The speaker will be Sri J.C. Nivas. The login timing should be at 11 o'clock. Session will start at 11:32. That is our service. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Recording.
Thank you. छठा महीना बहुत दिन हो गया। ठीक है।